I rise today to introduce the Roads Safe Act of 2010. And I'm pleased to be joined in introducing this legislation by my colleague, the Senator from Tennessee, Senator Bob Corker. This legislation will encourage the development of new tools to fight drunk driving and has the potential to save 8,000 lives every year. Tragic drunk driving crashes often prompt communities to do more to prevent drunk driving. This was the case in my home state of New Mexico back in 1992, when a drunk driver killed a mother and her three girls on Christmas Eve. He was speeding down the highway 90 miles an hour, going the wrong way down an interstate highway. This crash helped change attitudes in my state, but it should not take a tragedy for us to do more to prevent drunk driving. In 2008, drunk driving killed about 12,000 Americans, including 143 people in New Mexico. That is an average of 32 people killed every day by drunk driving. This unacceptable death toll is all the more shocking when you consider that each one of those deaths was preventable. The United States has already made significant progress. Compared to 20 years ago, our roads are much safer today. Yet even as the overall number of people killed on our highways has declined, drunk driving still accounts for about a third of all traffic fatalities. Excuse me. It's even more worrisome that a drunk driver has just a 2% chance of being caught. In fact, one study found that the first-time drunk driving offender has, on average, driven drunk 87 times before being arrested. Imagine, 87 times. This is unacceptable. Something must be done to prevent these drivers from getting on the road in the first place. The good news is that there are potential technologies out there that could do just that. That's why Senator Corker and I are introducing the Roads Safe Act today. New safety technology has already transformed the automobile and saved countless lives. For example, airbags and anti-lock brakes are now standard features in many vehicles. These safety devices are built into the car and are unobtrusive to the driver. Such technologies are an important reason we have fewer traffic fatalities today. Now imagine imagine a future with vehicles that could detect whether a driver is drunk when he or she gets behind the wheel, before he or she even starts their vehicle. That would be no drunk driving crashes if it were impossible for drunk drivers to drive. If such technology were widely deployed in cars, an estimated 8,000 lives could be saved every year. I realize that many may think this is a far-fetched idea, yet consider that vehicles today can already give driving directions thanks to GPS satellite navigation devices. Some cars can even parallel park themselves. New Mexico and other states require convicted drunk drivers to use an ignition interlock, a breathalyzer device they blow into before their vehicle's engine will start. The success of ignition interlocks for preventing repeat drunk driving offenses suggests that a better technology could be used to prevent all drunk driving. In 2006, Mothers Against Drunk Driving convened an international technology symposium in Albuquerque, New Mexico. The goal of the meeting was to review efforts to develop advanced ignition interlocks technology. In 2008, the National Highway Traffic Safety Administration partnered with leading automakers to explore the feasibility of in-vehicle technologies to prevent drunk driving. The recent progress of this cooperative effort fuels optimism that such technology could be deployed within 5 to 10 years. Clearly, such advanced technologies must win widespread public acceptance in order to be effective. They must be moderately priced, absolutely reliable, and unobtrusive to sober drivers. The aim is to stop drunk driving, not discourage responsible social drinking. A recent Insurance Institute for Highway Safety poll found that 64% of Americans believe that advanced alcohol detection technology is a good idea and that it's reliable. So what would the Road Safe Act do? This legislation would authorize $12 million in annual funding for 5 years for the Driver Alcohol Detection System for Safety Program, also known as DADS. DADS is a public-private partnership between NHTSA and the Automobile Coalition for Traffic Safety. The goal is to explore the feasibility, potential benefits, and public policy challenges associated with using in-vehicle technology to prevent drunk driving. This increased federal funding to combat drunk driving is a smart investment in public safety. Drunk driving has direct and indirect economic costs in terms of damaged property, medical bills, and lost productivity. In economic terms, drunk driving costs $129 billion per year. Of course, such monetary costs cannot be compared to the value of saving 8,000 lives every year. Several organizations dedicated to fighting drunk driving already support this bipartisan proposal. Mothers Against Drunk Driving, the Century Council, and the Distilled Spirits Council all support the Roads Safe Act. Madam President, I urge my Senate colleagues to join me, Senator Corker, and these important organizations in the fight against drunk driving by supporting the Roads Safe Act. We have made much progress in our efforts to prevent drunk driving, but there is so much more to be done.